हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल लिटरेरी थर्सडे। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू पोस्ट अ वीडियो ऑन पोस्ट कॉलोनियलिज्म। बट बिफोर वी डिस्कस अबाउट पोस्ट कॉलोनियलिज्म, वी हैव टू हैव अ फेयर अमाउंट ऑफ आइडिया अबाउट व्हाट कॉलोनियलिज्म इज। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। Colony comes from the 14th century term colony, C-O-L-O-N-Y-E, derived from the Latin colonus, that is farmer, cultivator or settler in a new country, as per Oxford English Dictionary. The term was used in connection with the Roman settlements in foreign lands. What is the concept of colonialism? European modernity dates back to the 15th and 16th centuries. Modernity emphasized rational and optimal use of resources to achieve maximum profits. This mechanism is directly linked with the economic system of capitalism. As European modernity, through the expansion of economics and industries, Europe needed more human resources, that is labor and raw materials, machineries and markets outside the continent. Thus, the European countries began to look at Asia, South America and Africa as sites providing them the much required resources. In this way, modernity directly led to voyages of discovery for trade routes and conquest for control over resources in other parts of the world. So colonialism had an economic motive to start with, where capitalist modes of production was the driving force. Coming to the definition of colonialism. Colonialism is the process of settlement by Europeans in non-European spaces, that is Asian countries, African countries, South American countries, Australian countries and so on and so forth. Colonialism, therefore, is a violent or exploitative conjugation where the sense of self develops through a negotiation rather than a separation, a relation rather than a disjunction with the other. Colonization often destroyed native cultures or altered them significantly, often producing new, that is hybrid forms. As per the definition provided by the Oxford English Dictionary, colonialism is an alleged policy of exploitation of backward or weak people by a large power. This powerful mode of exploitation is based on the difference in race, culture, forms of knowledge, political systems, and technological advancements. Now, people tend to get confused about what is colonialism and what is imperialism. I think through the lecture I have just done, the idea of colonialism is somewhat clear to all of you. Now, if that is the concept of colonialism, what is imperialism? It is the term that is often used in connection with colonialism. It is an ideology, that is rule of governance, that recommends and justifies colonial rule. Unlike colonialism, which implies direct settlement and governance, imperialism implies a remote control, often without actual settlement in the non-European spaces. That is, imperialism is an ideology-driven mechanism which proposes the colonial conquest of non-European nations for the sake of acquiring greater wealth. definition of decolonization, which obviously follows colonialism. Okay? Decolonization seeks freedom from colonial forms of thinking, a freedom to receive and rejuvenate native forms of knowledge. The concept particularly applies to the dismantlement of the colonial empires in the second half of the 20th century, demanding political independence, cultural separation, and nationalism. Now, there is a term linked with colonialism, that is neocolonialism. What is this? Neocolonialism is the practice of using economics, globalization, cultural imperialism, and conditional aid to influence a country which has otherwise gained political independence from colonial exploitation. For instance, American control over the rest of the world in the 21st century. That is, neocolonialism is the continuing economic infringement on the Asian and African nation states by European and American powers. Postcolonialism, a very important aspect related to colonialism, but not related to colonialism at the same time, because it is a term that follows from colonialism, of course. Post-colonialism means after colonialism, but it also protests colonization, protests against the detrimental aspects of colonization. So what is post-colonialism? Post-colonialism is the critical academic study of the cultural legacy of colonialism and imperialism, a method of reinterpreting, rereading, and thus critiquing the cultural practices of colonialism. History, literature, arts, discourse, legal systems, science, and other socio-cultural practices, where it proposes and challenges that the exercise of colonial power is also the racially determined powers of representation, in which the colonial does the representation and the native is represented. So, the colonial culture is always based on the issue of inequality and racial prejudice. The post-colonial thus expresses a whole new experience of political freedom, new ideologies, and new agenda. The sovereign nation state now asserts its independence by preparing its own program for economic and social development and by generating its own newer cultural forms, though influenced by the colonial experience. Post-colonial theory, however, has two basic ramifications. The first one, development of national consciousness, national culture, and national literature, where colonial narrators are rendered unreliable and literature is from the colonized's point of view. The second one, sustenance of a different form of colonialism, that is neocolonialism, where the native elites occupy the spaces of power, that is colonizer, to exploit and oppress the working classes, according to Franz Fanon. And here concludes the first part of my video. The next I will discuss in details about the major theorists of post-colonial theory. Thank you.